Greetings, Earthlings. I'm back with another interface review for you guys. So today I'm reviewing this guy, the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 second gen interface. If you are interested in this thing, it'll set you back around $150 on Amazon, as per usual, link in the description. And for this video, I have the Rode NT1 connected directly to the 2i2 second gen with phantom power on and my gain at around 45%, recording at 24-bit, 192 kHz. I'll do no post-processing or add any effects to the audio, but I may boost it in post, so check the doobly-doo for more information. Jesus Christ, that was a long one. And before we go any farther, I know people will ask, what's the difference between the first gen Scarlets and the second gen Scarlets? And according to Focusrite, they've improved the latency on the newer models, they've redesigned the gain structure to make it better for getting the right gain, they've redesigned the instrument inputs to resolve the clipping issue that a lot of people have had, and they've also made it a higher resolution, so now you can record up to 192 kilohertz. Now let's go ahead and talk about what comes in the box. Obviously, you're going to get the interface. You get a USB cable. You get minimal documentation because it's all online. And when you register your device, you get a bunch of free software. As far as the build quality, just like the first gen devices, this thing feels absolutely amazing. It has an all aluminum chassis that feels very rugged. The dials are all nicely attached, except for the headphone dial, which does wiggle around quite a bit, and the XLR ports are not loose at all. On the front of the interface, you're going to find two channels, which are the exact same. They each have an XLR combo jack, which accepts XLR or 6.3 millimeter cables. They have gain control dials that also have a ring light to indicate when you're getting a signal or when you're clipping. And they also have a switch to switch between line or instrument level inputs. Then in the main section, you have a plus 48 volts button to turn on or off phantom power for both channels' XLR ports. You have a direct monitor switch to turn on or off zero latency monitoring. You have a monitor dial to control the outputs on the back of the interface. You have a headphone volume control. And lastly, you have the 6.3 millimeter headphone output. On the back of the interface, you just have a couple of things. You have the USB plug, which allows you to connect this to your computer, and you have a set of 6.3 millimeter outputs to connect to your powered amp or powered monitors. In terms of specs, this thing has a bit depth of 24-bit, a sampling rate of 44.1 up to 192 kilohertz. It has plus 48 volts of phantom power that you can only turn on or off for both channels, and it has a gain range of 50 decibels. So right now you can see that our gain is at around 50%. I'm going to go ahead and drop this to zero and slowly increase it so you can hear what kind of line noise is generated by this preamp. Percent. 50%. percent. 75%. And 100%. Now I have the 2i2 connected to my Windows 10 PC with the exact same settings after downloading the Focusrite plugins and installing them, and this is how the audio sounds in this setup situation. And just to demonstrate the amount of gain that this thing does offer, I have the Shure SM7B connected directly to the 2i2 with my gain set at around 95 or 98%, and this is the level we're getting out of this setup. Now I'm going to go ahead and plug my guitar directly into the second channel's instrument input and show you how it sounds with some guitar processing as well as raw to give you an idea of how they've changed it. Now I'm speaking into the Rode NT1 connected directly to the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 second gen with the input gain at 45%, and this is how the audio sounds, and this is the level that we're getting. And now I have the NT1 connected directly to the Focusrite Scarlett Solo first gen with the Phantom Power on and my gain at 45% as well. And this is how the audio sounds, and these are the levels we're getting, which you can see are quite a bit lower than the Scarlett 2i2 second gen. So you can see here on the 2i2 that with an I/O buffer size of 64 samples, we have a round trip latency of 8.3 milliseconds with a sample size of 128, 11.2 milliseconds, and with a sample of 256, 17 milliseconds. On the Scarlett Solo with an I/O buffer of 64 samples, we have a round trip latency of 8.5 milliseconds. When we switch to 128, 11.5 milliseconds. And then at 256, 17.2 milliseconds. So to me, the improvement seems negligible. So overall, just like the first gen Scarlett Solo, I think this thing is an absolutely amazing buy. In terms of pros, this thing is just insanely well built. It has some really nice mic pres in it. It has a really good noise floor. The instrument inputs no longer clip, and you get a bunch of free software, so you're up and running right out of the box. And then in terms of cons, it doesn't have Phantom Power controls for each individual channel, which I would have liked to see. And also the headphone dial does wiggle around a bit, but there's nothing huge about that. So if you're looking for a relatively cheap interface that records high-res audio, has some really nice mic pres, and just does everything that you would expect an interface to do, I would highly recommend the Scarlett 2nd Gen series of interfaces. The gods agree, I guess. Now, if you do currently have one of the first gen models, I don't think it's necessary for you to upgrade. I think you're perfectly fine with what you have. But if you're new to the market and you're looking for a new interface and you have the option between the first and second gen series, I highly think you should go with the second gen over the first. All right, guys, I guess that'll do it for today. If you found this video fun, interesting, or helpful, thumbs up. If you thought it sucked, thumbs down. If you want to influence the gear that I review next, head over to geeksrising.com/podcast. And cast your votes there. If you want more videos just like this, subscribe by clicking the logo beneath me. Follow me on the social media stuff, links at the bottom of this screen, and I will see you all next Friday or this Friday. Talk to you later. Bye.